So, welcome again to the Be Love Tribe Vinyasa Flow class. This time we're going to work on forward folds and back release. And take care of your body always. If you have some injuries, please follow your own body. So opt out. If it's too much for you, choose your own version. I will give several options for you, so it's all level, everybody can join in, and you can always skip in Vinyasa or go to Child's Pose whenever you need it. And what we need today is a strap, something that resembles a strap, so maybe you have a belt at home or a necktie or something you can use, and a blanket, and of course a block or a book. It's always handy to have to help you. So if you have to take that now, pause the video, get your stuff, and we will meet up again on the mat. And today we're going to start with lying down on our back. So find your position, lying on your back, with your legs straight, and your arms alongside your body. Maybe your feet are a little bit wider than your hips. And find your position, land on the mat, take a moment to arrive in space, in time here, thanking yourself for taking some time to practice. When you found your position, plant your heels firmly in the mat. And start wiggling your toes back and forward. So your whole body is moving with the movement of your toes back and forward. Sort of a lazy shake. For our Be Love Tribers, we shake a lot, so we know what shaking is. But this is more lazy version. Lying on the back, shaking. Close your eyes and let your whole body immerse into shake. From your toes towards your crown. And open your mouth when you're breathing and let go of the breath on the shaking. Let go of the air, of the tension in your body. Jaw is relaxed and open, loose. The tongue is relaxed in the mouth. Shoulders away from the ears. Deep inhales and exhales and sigh it out with the shaking. One more deep breath in and out here. And slowly come to stillness. Let the shaking subside. And take a moment to feel the difference in your body. Maybe you feel some energy moving in your body. Maybe some tension or relaxation. Certain areas of the body. Maybe your heart rate is going a bit faster. Notice your breath. How is your breath after the shaking? Then on your next inhale, bring your right knee towards your chest. Interlace your fingers on your chin. And squeeze your knee into your chest. And on the next inhale, bring your nose towards your knee. Squeeze yourself into a little ball towards your knee. And on the exhale, gently let your head drop back on the mat. Stretch out your leg so your foot is facing the ceiling. And find your strap. Place your strap on the sole of your feet. So maybe you have to bend your knee a little bit to get your strap or your tie around your sole of your feet. And when you have it, stretch out your leg again and take hold of the strap. And gently bring your leg a little bit towards your face. So you stretch out the back of the leg. Make sure your left leg stays on the mat. Feet are flexed, both feet are flexed. And gently see if you can stretch your leg out a little bit more by pulling it towards you. Be careful, we're still warming up, so be gentle to your hamstring. And if it's too much, let go a little bit again. Play a little bit with where you are in the moment. Gently bring your back leg back to neutral. Take hold of the strap with your left hand. Bring your right arm in a T-shape next to your body. And on the exhale, move your right leg over to the left side, crossing your left leg, and see how far you can go, stretching out side of the legs. Hollowing out the belly with every out-breath. Maybe you can go a little bit deeper. Keep your gaze towards the ceiling. The rest of your body stays on the mat. Only your right leg moves with your left arm to the side, left side. One more deep in and exhale here. And on the next inhale, bring your leg back to neutral. Switch hands, so take the strap with your right hand. Place your left hand in T-shape next to you on the floor. And on the out-breath, bring your left or your right leg to the right as far as it will allow it to go. Maybe you can even place your left hand on your left hip to secure your hip on the floor, so you keep your hip bone on the floor. And see how far you can reach with your right leg to the right side. Opening up. Breathing towards the stretch. Deep breath in and out. Very good. Next inhale, bring your leg back to neutral. Let go of the strap. And gently let go of your leg. Bring your right leg back to the mat, straightening it out. And feel the difference between both legs, left and right. Maybe you feel a little bit difference in both legs. On the next inhale, bring your left knee towards your chest, interlace your fingers on your shin, and squeeze the leg into your chest. Breathing out, bring it a little bit closer to your chest. And the next in-breath, bring your nose towards your knee, squeeze yourself into a little ball. And on the exhale, let go of the head, bring the head back to the floor. Straightening out your leg, your left leg. Both feet are flexed. Right leg is completely on the floor. Take hold of your strap. Maybe you have to bend your leg a little bit to get your strap on the sole of your foot. Left foot, and take hold of the strap. Straighten your leg. Flex your foot. And see if you gently can pull your left foot towards you again, a little bit at the time, maybe pulsing a little bit. Feel what you need, what feels good for your body, for your hamstrings. With every out-breath, maybe you can go a little bit deeper. Mindful of the hamstrings, so you're still warming up. Don't go too far, too fast. And gently let go, bring your leg back to neutral. Take hold of the strap with your right hand. Bring your left arm, T-shape on the floor. And on the next exhale, bring your left leg over to the right side, crossing your right leg a little bit. See how far you can go. Deep stretch to the side of the leg. Keep your gaze towards the ceiling. The whole body is on the floor except for your left leg and right arm. Shoulders are relaxed, away from the ears. And maybe with every out-breath, hollow out your belly and see if you can get a little bit deeper into the side. And the next inhale, bring your leg back to neutral. Change your hand, so take hold of the strap with your left hand. Opening up the right arm to the side. And on the exhale, bring your left leg to the left side. Make sure your hips stay on the floor. So maybe you want to place your right hand on your right hip bone to help you secure your hips. See what feels best to you. See how far you can lower your left leg towards the left without coming away from the mat with the rest of your body. Keep both feet flexed. And breathe deeply in and out. See with the out-breath if you can get a little bit deeper. Little bit lower with your leg. Maybe you can, maybe you can't. It's all totally fine. Exploring our range at the moment, this morning. And the next inhale, bring your leg back. And let go of the strap. And release your leg towards the floor. Stretch them out. And again, feel how your legs are feeling right now. Both sides equal, or maybe they're still a little bit different. Now the next inhale, bring your legs towards your body. Squeeze yourself in a little ball. Bring your nose towards your knees. And exhale, bring your head back to the floor. Bring your hands behind your knees. And roll up and down the mat over your spine, massaging your spine. And the next time you come up, catch yourself in a boat position. So your legs are hovering in the air, arms straightening out, legs in a 90 degree angle with the mat, and your heart is open. Engage your abdominal muscles. And then we're going to tap the floor with our feet. First left, right, left, right, left, right. One more time. Left, right. Hold it on for a little bit more. And on an exhale, bring your both feet to the floor. Curl over your knees and give yourself a little hug. Releasing the tension in the abdominal muscles. And
little restoration. One more deep breath in and out here. This nice gentle hug. And on an inhale, bring yourself back with a straight spine. Keep your feet on the floor and your knees bent. Take hold of your knees with your hands. We're going to move into a slight constricted cat-cow. So see how this movement works for you. So cat-cow is when we're breathing in, we hollow out the back, opening the heart, draw our nose towards the ceiling, opening up. And in an out-breath, we're coming into cat, doming the spine. Bring our chin to our chest and curl ourselves up. So make this movement in your own breath and see how this slightly constricted cat-cow feels for you. It's a different version of cat-cow than we're used to. See what the difference is for your body. Take your time in your own breath. And if this doesn't work for you, for whatever reason, you can always come to all fours or cross your legs, cross-legged position, and take the cat-cow in that way. Two more times. Coming up, breathing in, nose towards the ceiling, hollow out the spine, and breathing out, doming the spine, chin to chest. One more time, breathing in. Draw your nose towards the ceiling, open up your heart. And breathing out, chin to chest, doming the spine. And breathing in, come back to neutral. Very good. Bring yourself towards a Sphinx position. Coming lying on your belly. Forearms on the mat. And fingertips are spreaded wide. Legs, feet are at hip width distance apart. And see how this little back bend feels for you. Find your pose. And find your comfortable way of being here. Then bring your left leg into a frog leg position. So that's with a bent knee in a 90 degree angle, bend your leg like a frog leg. And surrender your belly towards the mat. Little back bend with a frog leg. Breathe towards your lower back, towards your belly. Foot of your frog leg, left leg is flexed. And check if you're really in a 90 degree angle with your leg. So maybe you have to look back a little bit to see if you're placed correctly. Then bring your left hand forwards, straightening out the arm. And your right arm is going underneath your armpit. So thread the needle. Come lying on your right side. Your right ear for a gentle twist. You can either stay here if it feels enough for you, or you can even open up by bringing your left arm all the way towards the right, opening up into a twist. See how far you can move your body towards the mat. Maybe your shoulders touch the mat, maybe they don't. And breathe into this twist. Opening up towards the ceiling. Gaze, your drishti is towards the ceiling. Or stay in the first version. Keep on breathing. One more deep breath in. And on the out breath, bring yourself back towards Sphinx position. Bring your left leg back. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So your right leg comes into a frog leg. Make sure your leg is in a 90 degree angle. And flex your foot. And find your frog leg sphinx for a moment. Let your belly drop to the mat, surrendering to the mat. Feel what it does for your lower back, opening up the hip. Your gaze is towards the mat, just towards your thumbs. So your neck is in one curve with your spine. Then straighten out the right arm. And bring your left arm underneath your armpit, thread the needle. Come lying down on your left side, on your left shoulder and ear. For a gentle twist, maybe you want to stay here. This is enough for you, and maybe you want to come all the way over, bring your right hand towards the left side, opening up the body. See how far you can get your shoulders towards the floor. Opening up the heart towards the ceiling. Gaze towards the ceiling. And surrender to the twist. Keep on breathing. Deep, gentle breaths. You can always use your oceanic breath. Slight constriction in the back of the throat to hear yourself breathe. Warming up the body, slowing down the breath, bringing more mindfulness into your practice. One more deep breath in. And breathing out, coming back towards your sphinx. Turn yourself over again. Straighten your legs. Bring your hands underneath your shoulders and push yourself up towards all fours. Find your all fours. Maybe you want to move your back a little bit to get the tension out from the Sphinx pose. Now on the next inhale, bring your left leg all the way to the side, straightening it out. Place your foot on the floor. And walk yourself up towards a gate pose. Keep your left hand on your hip. And on an out-breath, bring your right hand down towards the floor for a gentle stretch. Inhale, lift your left leg from the floor. Keep your foot flexed. See if you can make some gentle pulses here out of the hip socket, warming up the hip joint, the leg, bringing some strength into the warming up. Keep on pulsing up and down with the feet, the foot. Keep on breathing. Make sure you keep your tailbone tucked in slightly so you're not collapsing in your spine. And on the next exhale, bring your foot back down. And inhale, opening up from the left arm over your head into a complete stretched gate pose. Straightening up the arm, straightening out the leg. So you're one straight line from the knife edge of your foot to the tips of your fingers. And the next in-breath, help yourself up. Cartwheel the hands up. And exhale, bring your left hand on your left leg. Bring your right arm up and overhead and come into a side stretch on the other side. Gently sliding your left hand over your left leg. Down, keep the heart open, little bit towards the ceiling. And then the next inhale, come back to neutral. Exhale, bring your hands back down and come back to all fours. For the other side. So bring your right leg towards the side, opening up, stretching it out, and walk yourself towards a straight spine gate pose. Find your position so your right leg is straight, your foot is planted firmly into the floor, parallel to the side of the mat. Keep your right hand on your right hip and bring your left hand down for a gentle stretch. Next inhale, bring your right foot into the air. Keep your foot flexed. Toes are pointing forward. And start pulsing the foot up and down to warm up the hip joint, the leg. Maybe also bring some heat into the arm you're balancing on, warming up the body. Keep your spine nice and tall. Curl your tailbone under a little bit to not collapse in your spine. And on the next exhale, bring your foot down again. And inhale, opening up through your right arm all the way up and overhead, stretching out. Gate pose, side stretch. One line from the knife edge of your foot to your fingertips. Slightly opening up the heart towards the ceiling. Inhale, cartwheel yourself up. And exhale, bring your right hand on your right leg. And opening up your arm, left arm up and overhead, and slide your left right hand over your right leg towards the side, stretch the other way around. Keep your heart open towards the ceiling a little bit. Don't collapse in your spine. Inhale, come all the way up. Straight, and exhale, bring your hands towards the mat to all fours. Curl your toes under. And then the next inhale, gently with bended knees, bring yourself up towards a bent knee, downward facing dog. First, find your position with your hands. Place your hands correctly so you're planted firmly in the floor with your hands on the mat. Fingers are spread wide, index fingers pointing forwards. Arms are straightening out, back is straightening out. The pits of your elbows are pointing upward, so you're sort of twisting your elbow pits up towards the ceiling, rounding through your shoulders, opening up, stretching the back. And when you feel you found your alignment, you can gently stretch out your legs, maybe walk your dog a little bit to find your downward facing dog. Finding stillness in the position. Feet are hip distance apart. Neck is nice and loose. Maybe you want to shake your head a little bit, yes and no, to make sure there's no tension in the neck. And take a deep breath in and out. Maybe on the side out here. Inhale, look towards your hands and walk slowly to the front of your mat. Keep your knees bent as much as you need to. Feet are hip distance apart. Your belly and thighs are connected. Let your head hang heavy and take hold of opposite elbows with your hands, coming into ragdoll. Feel your spine elongating here. Maybe you want to sway a little bit back and forth. Get all the tension out. Bend your knees a little bit more. Head is heavy, jaw is loose and soft. Next, exhale, release the hands, bring them to the mat. And inhale, vertebra by vertebra, roll yourself up towards a standing position, Tadasana, mountain pose.
To the front of the mat. Maybe you have to walk a little bit forward. Take your time to arrive in your Tadasana. Feet are hip-width distance apart. Your weight is equally divided in all four corners of the feet. Legs are activated. Shoulders are away from the ears and down to the back. Spine straight. Chin is slightly tucked in. Find your breath. Close your eyes and bring your hands in Anjali Mudra in front of your heart to set your intention for this class. What is it that you need today for yourself or for somebody else? Something else. And with the next deep breath in, breathe in your attention fully to your whole body. And exhale, gently release your intention in full trust and love. And let go of your hands alongside your body. I'm going to start with the flows. Inhale, bring your hands up and overhead. And exhale, hinge from the hips, forward, forward fold, swan dive down, forward fold. Maybe you need to bend your knees. See what you need. Inhale, halfway lift. Maybe your fingertips are on the mat or your hands are on your legs. Exhale, forward fold and step towards your plank. Find your alignment. Hands are stacked underneath the shoulders, shoulder distance apart. Your whole body is active. Gaze is down. And exhale, bring your knees towards the floor and in one straight line, bring yourself towards the floor, nose to the mat. Opening up your legs a little bit wider than hip-width distance. Bring your hands next to your face. And the next inhale, bring yourself up out of your hands into baby cobra. Back bend. Keep the weight off of your hands to see if all the action comes from your back. And exhale, come back down. Nose towards the mat. Inhale towards all fours. And exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, look to your hands. And take your right leg with you. Plant your right leg in between your hands and your left knee onto the mat. Low lunge. Inhale, arms up for crescent moon. Hips are straight forward, parallel to the forwards of the mat. And exhale, bring your hands towards your heart. Curl your left toe under. And the next inhale, bring yourself up to a high lunge. Slight engagement of the gluteus muscles to protect the lower back. And the next inhale, straighten out your front leg. Totally swivel on your back foot and walk your foot in a little bit to shorten your stance. And bring your left foot into a warrior one position again. So your hips are still forward towards the front of the mat. Place your hands on your hips, in your hip crease. And the next inhale, lengthen out your spine. And exhale, bend from the hip crease forward with a straight spine. Halfway forward. And maybe this is enough for you. You want to stay here. Active legs. Tadasana feet. Feet are firmly planted into the floor. A slight, really mini micro bend into the knees. So don't lock your knees, because that's very bad for the knee joint. So keep them free a little bit with a little micro bend. And again, you can stay here, or maybe you want to come a little bit deeper. Bring your hands down towards the mat and place them on the mat with the fingertips pointing down to the back of the mat. You can also take some blocks or books if it's too much. And bring your nose towards your knee. Ekka Paddha Uttanasana, one-legged forward fold. It's also sort of triangle because you're making all kinds of triangle shapes with your body in this pose. Keep on breathing. Protect your knees with the light micro bend. One more deep breath in and out here. And next inhale, help yourself up. Bring your hands into a Jali Mudra. And exhale, bend your front leg. Coming back into the high lunge. And the next exhale, bring your hands down. Stepping to plank. Straight, strong ear plank. And then the next exhale, help yourself into a downward facing dog. So we're skipping the vinyasa, coming straight into downward facing dog. Inhale, look to the front. And bring your left foot with you towards the front of the mat. Place it in between your hands. Lower your right knee. And coming into a low lunge, inhale, hands, arms up overhead, crescent moon. Very good. Opening the heart, proud pose. Exhale, bring your hands towards your heart, Anjali Mudra. Curl the right toes under, and the next inhale, straightening out your right leg, coming into a high lunge. And on the next inhale, straightening out the left leg, swivel on your right foot and walk your foot in a little bit to shorten your stance. When you find your right angle, come back on your foot again in Warrior One position. Hips are moving straight forward along the forwards of the mat. Bring your hands towards your hips. Inhale, straighten your spine, and exhale, bend with a straight spine, forward fold, halfway. Gaze is down, focused on one point. And maybe you want to stay here if this is enough for you. Keep your legs both straight, micro bend in the knee. Feet are firmly planted into the mat, Tadasana feet. And if this is already enough for you, and it's a challenge to not collapse into your legs, keep your legs straight, and that's fine. If you want to go a little bit deeper, let go of the hands, plant the hands on the mat, and walk them back with the fingertips facing to the back of the mat and come into a deeper forward fold, Ekka Paddha Uttanasana. Nose towards the knee. Arms are straight, legs are straight. And breathe. One more deep in and exhale here. Maybe you want to sigh it out.
And the next inhale, come all the way up. The same way as you came in. Hands in front of the heart. And exhale, bend the left knee, coming into a high lunge. And then on your next exhale, bring your hands towards the floor and step towards plank. Active in plank, strong pose. And on the next exhale, come all the way into downward facing dog. Bring yourself back to downward facing dog. Inhale, look to the front. And walk slowly to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up. Arms up and overhead. Slide back bend, baby back bend. And exhale, hands in front of the heart. Samastiti. Good job. Going to the next flow. Feet are staying at hip width distance apart. Inhale, arms up and overhead. And exhale, swan dive down from the hips to a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, step to plank. And this time you're not going to skip the vinyasa, so now we're going to do the vinyasa. As this is a vinyasa flow class. So on an exhale, bring your knees down to the mat and in one straight line, come all the way down towards the mat. Opening up your legs, a little bit wider than hip width distance. Bring your hands underneath your shoulders, coming up for a full cobra now. On your inhale, coming up, push yourself out of your hands. Keep your pubic bone in the mat, shoulders away from the ears. Press yourself up. When you feel you find your range, then you can draw up your nose a little bit to bring your spine all in one curve, your neck. And exhale, come back down. Nose towards the mat. Inhale, up to all fours. And exhale, downward facing dog. Bring your feet together. And the next inhale, bring your left leg up, three-legged dog, and open up your hips. Stack your hips on top of each other so your toes are pointing towards the wall. And then bend your right knee, peeing dog. See if you can keep your weight equally divided on both hands. And maybe if you look underneath your armpit, your left armpit, you can find your feet, your foot, your right foot. Maybe you can, maybe you can't. See if you can find it. Make some circles with your ankle one way and the other way. Warming up, loosening up the ankle joint. And inhale, come back to three-legged dog. And exhale, way to the front. Take your right foot with you and place it in between your hands. Swivel on your back leg. And inhale, cartwheel your hands up for warrior two. Check your alignment. So your right knee is bent, stacked on your right ankle. Both feet are firmly planted in the mat. Front knee is twisting outwards. So you can still see your big toe and your hips and spine are stacked together. Arms are straight in one line. Inhale, flip your front palm over to the ceiling and exhale, come into a reversed warrior. Right arm up and overhead, bending backwards. Inhale, come back to warrior two, straightening the legs, bring the foot to the front and coming to a straddle pose. Your feet are pointing out a little bit, bring your hands towards your hips and bending your knees coming into a goddess. So your feet are pointing out, your toes are pointing out into a goddess pose. Knees are also opening up, so you're opening up the hips. And your hands are on your hip creases, opening up the heart. Find your pose. Breathe. And when you find a stable position, bring your arms in cactus shape. Arms strong, opening up a little bit more through the heart. And the next inhale, stretch out the arms and the legs up. And then exhale, bend your arms and your legs back into cactus goddess pose. Inhale, straighten everything out. And exhale back to goddess cactus. Two more times. Inhale, bring everything up, straightening out. Exhale, bend your knees, bend your arms, opening through the heart. One more time. Inhale, straightening everything out. And exhale, come into cactus goddess. And stay here for a couple of breaths. Maybe you can sink a little bit deeper into your hips, bending your knees a little bit deeper. Make sure your tailbone is still tucked under. Keep on breathing. And last breath in. And next out breath, stepping back into warrior two. Bring your left or right elbow on your right knee. And inhale, bring your left arm up and overhead, extended warrior. See if you can bend a little bit deeper in your hip area, opening up through the hips. Exhale, look down, bring your hands down, stepping back into plank and moving to your vinyasa. Exhale, knees down. Come all the way down in one straight line. Opening up the legs a little bit, hands underneath the shoulders. And inhale, coming up for cobra. Shoulders away from the ears, pressing out of your hands. And exhale, come back down, nose towards the mat. Inhale all the way up. Hands and knees, and exhale into downward facing dog. Same flow on the other side. Bring the feet together first. And the next inhale, bring your left leg up. Three-legged dog, opening up the hip. Bend your knee. Try to keep your weight equally divided on both hands. And see if you can find your foot underneath your armpit. Opening up the hip towards the ceiling, stacking the hip together, and maybe make some circles with your ankle, one way, the other way, and coming back into three-legged dog. And the next exhale, bring your weight forward, take your left leg with you and plant your foot in between your hands, swivel on your back leg. And the next inhale, cartwheel your hands up for warrior two on the other side. Check your alignment. Knee above the ankle. Knee is turned out. Arms are one straight line. And the hips and the spine are stacked on top of each other. Inhale, opening up the front palm, and exhale, coming into a reversed warrior. Left arm up and overhead, back bend, nose towards the ceiling, heart is open. One more inhale, and exhale, coming back to warrior two, straightening both legs, and coming into straddle pose. The other side. I will turn so you can
see me a little bit better. So, but you can stay where you want to stay. Opening up the feet again, so the toes are pointing outwards. Bending the knees, coming into your goddess pose. Hands are on the hip creases. Tuck your tailbone in. Weight is equally divided on the legs and on the feet. And your chin is tucked in a little bit also. Straight spine. Next inhale, bring your arms up and overhead. Bend your elbows and take hold of opposite elbows above your head. Inhale, lengthen the spine. And exhale, come into a side bend to the right side. Stretching to the right side. Stretching out the whole left side of the body. Inhale, coming back to center. Lengthen out and exhale. Stretch the other side. So stretch to the left, opening up the right side of the body. Keep the knees bent. Keep on breathing. And inhale, come back. Straight and exhale, let go of the arms and stepping back into your warrior. Exhale, bring your left elbow to your left knee and opening up to extended warrior, right arm up and overhead. Heart is open, lightly towards the ceiling. Gazes towards the ceiling. Maybe you bend a little bit deeper in your legs. And the next exhale, look down. Bring your hands down and step into plank. And moving to your vinyasa of choice. So you can either do knees down, lie down, cobra, or come to chaturanga, upward facing dog, meeting up in downward facing dog. So you choose, and if you feel like you need to skip a vinyasa, come to child's pose, totally fine. Choose your option. Meeting up in downward facing dog. Looking forward, and an inhale. And walk, step, or jump to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. And next inhale, come all the way up. And exhale, hands in front of the heart, Anjali Mudra. And I will step towards the front of my mat again to be in line with you guys. Take a breath. Good job. Inhale, arms up and overhead. And exhale, swan dive down, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, and exhale, step towards plank. And keep yourself up in plank for a little moment. Engage your abdominal muscles, your gluteus muscles. Actively pushing yourself away from the mat, your hands and your toes. And on your next exhale, in one straight line, bring yourself down towards the mat. Very good. Going to move towards the back bends. So find yourself comfortably on your belly. Bring your hands next to your face. Your feet are a little bit wider than your hips. Going to move into locust and then into bow pose. So keep your gaze down, noses towards the mat. And the next inhale, bring your legs and your hands simultaneously up. Your gaze is still down. Coming up out of the hands, out of the legs, to the first variation of locust. Keep on breathing, bending the back. Engaging the gluteus muscles, engaging the legs,
And on an exhale, bring yourself down. Make a pillow with your hands and come into constructive rest in between the locust variations. Deep breath in and out towards the belly. Last sigh out. And coming back into position again. Find your legs in the right position. Stretching out your arms in front of you. If you want, you can always stay in the first variation of locust. This is one deeper variation. I'm going to build it up, but choose whatever you need to do. So straightening out your arms if you want to. Next inhale, bringing the arms and the legs all the way up. Back bend, chest is from the mat. See how far you can get your legs off the mat. Gaze is still down, nose is pointed towards the mat. Neck is straight. Keep on breathing towards the belly. One more deep in breath, maybe come a little bit higher. And exhale, come back down towards the mat. Make a little pillow with your hands and come into constructive rest. Deep breathing, slow down your heart rate with your breath. I'm going to move into the last variation of locust before we go to full bow pose. So bring your legs back into position. Bring your hands back and interlace your hands behind your back, straightening out the arms. Bring your shoulders towards each other, so squeeze your shoulders towards each other. And the next inhale, bring your legs up and pull your hands away from the body. Pull yourself into a shoulder squeeze. Chest is away from the mat, opening up your gaze a little bit to the front, a little bit higher. Keep pulling your hands away from the body towards the ceiling. Keep on breathing. Pointing the toes, active legs. And on the next exhale, come back down. Make a pillow of your hands and come into constructive rest once more before you go to full variation of bow pose. And again, if this is enough for you, you can always stay here. Choose one of the other variations. Take care of your body, what you need at the moment. Come back to child's pose. To release your back. One more deep breath in and out here. You want to sigh it out. And get yourself ready for bow pose. So bend your knees. Feet are coming towards your sit bones. Bring your hands back and take hold of your feet with your hands. See what is best for you. Maybe it's on the outside of your ankles. Maybe it's on the inside. It's different for everybody. So choose your variation. Get ready. And the next inhale, press your hands and feet towards each other. So press your feet out of your hands. Sort of protraction action. And come up from the chest. Thighs off of the mat. See how high you can get. Keep your knees hip width distance apart to protect them. One more deep breath in, maybe a little bit higher. And exhale, come back down into a little rest. Good job. Inhale, help yourself up, opening up your knees as wide as the mat, toes are touching, and come sit down for child's pose. Bring your hands next to your face so that your arms can really relax. And come into your own little child's pose cave. Focus on the breath. Slowing down the breath. Steady breath, steady mind, steady heart. That was most of the hard work. Now we're going to the inversion, the cooling down. So in the next breath, help yourself up into a seated position.
Swivel on your legs and bring your legs in front of you. Come sitting, straight legs. Maybe move the extra flesh away from your sit bones. Straight spine, if you need to sit on a blanket to straighten out your spine a little bit, you can always do that. Helps to tilt your pelvic bone a little bit forward, so you straighten your spine a little bit. Opening up the legs into a straddle. Inhale, lengthen your spine, flex your foot, both feet, and exhale, walk yourself towards a forward fold with a domed spine. Let yourself gently surrender to a forward fold, doesn't matter where you land. Releasing the back after the bow pose and locust poses. Give yourself some back release. Head is heavy, jaw is soft and loose. Arms are relaxed. Maybe your eyes are closed. Keep on breathing. Maybe you sink a little bit deeper with every out breath. And maybe you don't. It's all good. Whatever your body needs right now. The next inhale, plant your hands in the mat and walk yourself in a forward fold towards the right side, bending over your right leg. Maybe find your knee with your nose. Head is heavy, neck is relaxed. Bending over your right leg. Gentle side stretch. Inhale, coming back on your hands and walk yourself in the forward fold towards the other side, to the left, your own pace. Find your left leg with your hands and bend over towards your knee with your nose. Forward fold on the other side. Gentle side stretch. Inhale, walk yourself back to the middle. And gently help yourself up
Walk yourself up to a seated position. Help your knees back. Stretch your legs out in front of you. Very good. So we're going to move into our inversion. And I want to do the shoulder stand today. That's why you need your blanket, to help you release your neck a little bit in the shoulder stand. So get your blanket if you have it. If your blanket is not enough, you can always fold out your mat to get a little bit more cushioning for your shoulders so your neck stays free. See what you need. And if you don't want to do a shoulder stand, you can always come into the Viparita Karani we did before, the broken candle with the block or the book underneath your sacrum and coming up with your legs like this. So choose your option. I'm going to do the shoulder stand so you can come with me in that, or choose your more restorative option. So find your position. Make sure your shoulders, top of your shoulders, are on the edge of the blanket, so your neck is free to move, so you don't crunch your neck into the shoulder stand. Your feet are placed on the mat and knees are bent. And find your position. Your whole back is straight, spine is straight. Take a deep in and out breath here. And the next in breath, plant your hands into the mat and bring your feet up towards the ceiling and see if you can find yourself up more and more, helping your body up with your hands on your back, bringing your feet towards the ceiling, coming into shoulder stand. See if you can walk your elbows a little bit towards each other and support your lower back with your hands. Soles of the feet are soft, opening up towards the ceiling. Your gaze is up. Keep your neck straight. Don't look to the left or the right. Just keep your gaze up towards your feet. Keep on breathing. Big, deep breaths in and out. Maybe you want to stay here. And if you feel like naturally your feet are wanting to move over your head, bend your knees and bring your knees close to your head, next to your head, for a variation of plow pose with bent knees. Bring your foot towards the floor and see how far you can go into a bent plow. And only if your feet touch the floor, you can bring your interlace your hands and push yourself out of the floor with your hands a little bit deeper into the pose. But only if your feet touch the floor, so you have stability, you don't crunch your neck. Otherwise, keep your hands on the small of your back to support you and give you stability in the pose. Keep on breathing. This may look a little bit funny, but nobody's watching. You're in your own space, in your own home, safe. So take your time, explore yourself in this pose. One more deep breath in and out. And if you have your hands interlaced, release them, bring them back to the small of your back and gently release your toes from the floor, coming back, bend knees back into stretch leg and on top of you, shoulder stand, and then vertebra by vertebra roll down, Bring yourself down all the way up to the floor again, lying down, supine position. Help yourself up a little bit and remove your blanket. Come and lying down on top of your arms with your hand palms facing down. So bring your arms all the way straight, stretched underneath your body. See where your hand palms end up. Some people have shorter arms, the hands are underneath their sit bones. Some people have longer arms and their hands are more underneath their thighs. Upper legs, just depends on your body. If you found your position, inhale, push yourself out of your forearms up, your chest up, bend your head to come under your crown and release on an exhale, coming into fish pose. It's a gentle restorative pose after the plow pose we just did. To release the back, let go of all the muscle tension. Opening up the mouth, keep on breathing. Deep breath in and out. And then the next in-breath, push yourself out of your forearms, bring your head back in neutral position and breathe out, come back lying down on your back for final relaxation, Savasana. Find your Savasana, you did a great job, worked very hard. And find your relaxation, maybe you open up your legs, your feet are as wide as the mat. Your arms are next to your body, a little bit away from the body, hand palms facing up. And maybe if you feel some tension in the back of the lower part of your back because of all the forward folds, you can also come in constructive rest. Bring your knees up, plant your feet into the mat, mat with distance apart, and drop your knees together. This way you release your lower back a little bit. So find your Savasana. When you found your Savasana, come into stillness. Slowing down the breath. Deepening the breath. And with every out breath, come more and more into stillness. Sinking deeper and deeper into the mat. Find your body become more and more heavy. Find your final relaxation, integration. Let go of everything that happened or didn't happen during the practice. And relax your whole body. Let go of all the tension. And then it's time to come back into the space. Gently deepen your breath, waking up again. Find yourself on the mat in this space. Maybe take a deep breath in and sigh it out. One more time, breathing in and deep sigh out. Start bringing some movement in your fingers and toes. Maybe turn your head left and right, waking up a little bit more. If you like, you can stretch yourself out completely or curl yourself up in a little ball. Give yourself one last big hug, thanking your body for the hard work today. And find yourself to one of your sides to slowly come up into a seated position with your eyes closed, your hands in front of your heart. And again, thank yourself for taking this time, arriving on your mat, doing this hard work, giving your body this attention, this love, this nourishing movement. And bringing your mind, your heart, and your body more in alignment to each other. So there's more unity inside your whole being. Bring your hands to your forehead for kind thought. Your hands to your lips for kind speech. And your hands to your heart for kind intention. Thank you so much for practicing with me today. Namaste. Sat Nam.